Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 11. The subject is Engineering Thermodynamics. So we are going to solve a few more questions on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics from various gate question papers. And these are all the books I have written: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube where I upload the video lectures on the above subjects for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. Also, I am uploading the solution for gate question paper in the YouTube channel. So you please subscribe the channel and it will be useful, and use the channel for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. And this is the first question of this lecture. So from 2010 question paper, 1 kg of water at room temperature is brought into contact with the high temperature thermal reservoir. The entropy change of the universe is option A, equal to entropy change of the reservoir, option B, equal to entropy change of water, option C, equal to zero, and option D, always positive. So this is the heat transfer. 1 kg of water at room temperature is brought into contact with the high temperature thermal reservoir. So there is a heat transfer between high temperature thermal reservoir and the water at room temperature. The heat transfer occurs at the finite temperature difference. So the entropy change, the process is irreversible for finite temperature difference, and the change in entropy is always positive. So the correct answer is option D. For this particular process, the entropy change is always positive. And this is from the 2014 question paper. Which one of the following equation describe an irreversible heat engine? So the four options are given. Option A, del Q is greater than 0 and the cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than 0. Option B, cyclic integral of del Q is less than 0 and cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than 0. And option C, cyclic integral of del Q is greater than 0 and cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0. And option D, cyclic integral of del Q is less than 0 and cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0. So from the inequality of Clausius, so we have three conditions for three different types of cycle. So if cyclic integral del Q by T is equal to 0, the cycle is reversible. And if the cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than equal to 0, the cycle is irreversible and possible. If cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. But here the condition given is irreversible process. So for irreversible process, option A is the correct answer. So del Q is, cyclic integral of del Q is greater than 0 and cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than 0. It is the condition for irreversible process. And this question is from 2018 question paper. An ideal gas undergoes a process from state 1, where the temperature is 300 Kelvin and pressure is 100 kilopascal, to a state 2, where the temperature is 600 Kelvin and the pressure is 500 kilopascal. The specific heat of ideal gas are Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.7 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The change in specific entropy of the ideal gas from state 1 to 2 in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin is dash, and it is correct to the 2 decimal point. So we have to calculate. So this is a general process where the pressure and temperature changes are given. So the change in entropy for the process, for any process, delta S equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. And the R value we have to calculate from the given property. R equal to Cp minus Cv equal to 1 minus 0.7 equal to 0.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And substituting numerical values, delta S equal to 1 into logarithmic of 600 by 300 minus 0.3 into logarithmic of 500 by 100 equal to 0.21 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and the correct answer is 0.21 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin is the change in specific entropy of the ideal gas. And this is again the question from the 2018 question paper. For an ideal gas with constant properties undergoing a quasi-static process, which one of the following represent the change in entropy from state 1 to 2? So we have four options. Delta S equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. Delta S equal to Cv into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus Cp into logarithmic of V2 by V1. Delta S equal to Cp logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus Cv into logarithmic of P2 by P1. Or delta S equal to Cv into logarithmic of T2 by T1 plus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So the correct option is A. Answer is A. So delta S equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1 is the correct answer for any quasi-static process. We will see how. So the specific enthalpy of an ideal gas, H equal to U plus PV. And differentiating this equation, dH equal to dU plus differentiating PV, PdV plus VdP. And we have from the first law of thermodynamics, del Q equal to dU plus PdV. So, rearranging the terms, dH minus VdP equal to del Q. And from the second law of thermodynamics, we have TdS equal to del Q. So, substituting for del Q, TdS equal to dH minus VdP. So, TdS equal to dH equal to Cp into dT. For perfect gas and minus RT by P, specific volume equal to RT by P from the perfect gas equation into TP, DP. So, dividing by T. So, left hand side dS equal to Cp into dT by T minus R into dP by P. So, integrating this equation, delta S equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So, that is what the option here. So, option A is Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. And this is from 2019 question paper. Air of mass 1 kilogram initially at 300 Kelvin and 10 bar is allowed to expand isothermally till it reaches a pressure of 1 bar. Assuming air as an ideal gas with gas constant of 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, the change in entropy of air in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin round off to 2 decimal places is dash. So, we have to calculate the change in entropy for the isothermal process for the given pressure change. And the change in specific entropy for isothermal process, delta S equal to MR into logarithmic of P1 by P2, which is equal to M equal to 1 kilogram and R equal to 0.287, logarithmic of P2 is 10 bar. P1 is 10 bar and P2 equal to 1 bar, so 10 by 1. So, calculating 0.66 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, the change in entropy of the process, isothermal process, is 0.66 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is from the question paper 1993. Figure below shows a reversible heat engine ER having heat interaction with the 3 constant temperature systems. Calculate the thermal efficiency of the heat engine. So, we have heat engine interacting with 3 reservoirs. One is T1 at 1000 Kelvin, where the heat supply is 100 kilojoules. Another resource is T2, which is 500 Kelvin, and Q2 equal to 50 kilojoules. And another reservoir, which is T3 equal to 300 Kelvin, where the heat is supplied by the heat engine. Heat is rejected by the heat engine. So, for this heat engine, so for reversible cycle, so, Q1 by T1 plus Q2 by T2 minus Q3 by T3 equal to 0. So, Q1, Q2, they are heat supplied and Q3 is heat rejected. So, it is minus Q3 by T3 and substituting the value Q1 equal to 100 by 1000 plus Q2 equal to 50 by 500 minus Q3 is the unknown divided by 300 equal to 0 and rearranging. So, Q3 by 300 equal to 100 by 1000 plus 50 by 500 equal to 2 by 10. So, Q3 equal to 2 by 10 into 300 equal to 60 kilojoules. So, the answer is heat rejected is 60 kilojoules and efficiency equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by the heat supplied. So, heat supplied equal to Q1 plus Q2. So, 100 plus 50 equal to 150 minus 60 divided by 150 equal to 0.6 equal to 60%. So, the thermal efficiency of the heat engine is 60%. So, next question is from 1995 question paper. 1 kilomole of an ideal gas is throttled from an initial pressure of 0.5 megapascal to 0.1 megapascal. The initial temperature is 300 Kelvin. The entropy change of the universe is, there are four options given, 13.38 kilojoules per Kelvin, option B 4014.3 kilojoules per Kelvin, option C 0.0446 kilojoules per Kelvin, and option D minus of 0.0446 kilojoules per Kelvin. So it is a throttling process. So delta S equal to n RO into logarithmic of P1 by P2. So this is equal to 1 into number of moles equal to 1 kilomole. So 1 into 8.314. So this RO, we are using RO because the gas is not given and you are given number of moles. So n RO into logarithmic of P1 by P2. So 1 into 8.314 into logarithmic of P1 is 0.5 megapascal divided by P2 is 0.1 megapascal. So the answer is 13.38 kilojoules per Kelvin. So the correct answer is 13.38 kilojoules per Kelvin. The next question is from 2003 question paper. Consider the relationship TdS equal to dU plus PdV between the entropy, internal energy, pressure P and temperature T and the volume V. Which one of the following statement is correct? It is applicable only for reversible process. Option B, for irreversible process, TdS is greater than dU plus PdV. It is valid only for ideal gases. It is equivalent to first law for a reversible process. So, from the four options, the correct answer is from the first law of thermodynamics, del Q equal to dU plus PdV, and we have del Q equal to TdS. So, TdS equal to dU plus PdV. So, this equation is applicable to equivalent to first law for a reversible process. Next question, it is a combined question from the question paper, 2003 question paper. Nitrogen gas of molecular weight 28 is enclosed in a cylinder by a piston at initial condition of 2 bar 298 Kelvin and 1 meter cube. At a particular process, the gas slowly expands under isothermal conditions until the volume becomes 2 meter cube. The heat exchange occurs with the atmosphere at 298 Kelvin during this process. Question number 1. The work interaction for the nitrogen gas, there are 4 options, 200 kilojoules, 138.6 kilojoules, 2 kilojoules, minus 200 kilojoules. And second question, the entropy change for the system during this process in kilojoules per Kelvin is, there are 4 options again, 0.4652 kilojoules per Kelvin, 0.0067 kilojoules per Kelvin, and 0 kilojoules per Kelvin, minus of 0.6711 kilojoules per Kelvin. For the first question, the answer is 138.6 kilojoules. For the second question, the answer is 0.4652 kilojoules per Kelvin. The answers are given in the next slide. So, the given data, molecular weight of nitrogen is 28 and the P1 equal to 2 bar, T1 equal to 298 Kelvin and V1 equal to 1 meter cube, V2 equal to 2 meter cube. The gas constant for nitrogen, R equal to RO by molecular weight of nitrogen, universal gas constant divided by the molecular weight of nitrogen, 8.314 divided by 28 equal to 0.2969 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Mass of the nitrogen M equal to, from the ideal gas equation, P1 V1 divided by RT1 equal to 200 into 1 divided by 0.2969 into 298 equal to 2.26 kilogram. Work for the isothermal process. So, for isothermal process, work done equal to heat transfer MRT1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1. So, 2.26 into 0.2969 into temperature T1 equal to 298. Into logarithmic of 2 by 1 equal to 138.59 kilojoules. So, work done equal to 138.59 kilojoules and change in entropy equal to delta S equal to Q by T. So, for isothermal process, work done equal to heat transfer. So, 138.6 divided by 298 equal to 0.465 kilojoules per kilogram. So, that is what the option we have selected here. So, the work done equal to 138.6 kilojoules and change in entropy equal to 0.4652 kilojoules per Kelvin. So, these are all the answers. So, next question from 2005 question paper. A vapor absorption refrigeration system is a heat pump with a 3 thermal reservoir as shown in the figure. A refrigeration effect of 100 watts is required at 250 Kelvin when the heat source available is at 400 Kelvin. Heat rejection occurs at 300 Kelvin. The minimum value of heat required in watt is, there are four options. Option A, 167 watts. Option B, 100 watts. Option C, 80 watts. And option D, 20 watts. So, this is the refrigerator. So, it is a refrigeration effect is required 100 watt at 250 Kelvin. So, this is the amount of heat rejected and heat extracted by the refrigerator and the heat source available at 400 Kelvin. So, this is the source which is supplying the energy and the heat rejected at 300 Kelvin. So, this is the layout from the data given and the answer is 80 watts. We will see how the answer is 80 watts in the next slide. So, this is the diagram as in the previous page. Now, for a reversible cycle, we have Q1 by T1 minus Q2 by T2 plus Q3 by T3 equal to 0. So, Q1 is positive as it is supplied to the refrigerator. Q3 is also positive, it is supplied to the refrigerator. Q2 is rejected, so it is negative. So, substituting Q1 by 400 minus Q2 by 300 plus 100 by 250 equal to 0. Now, the heat supplied equal to heat rejected actually. Q1 plus 100 equal to Q2. Q1 plus 100 equal to Q2. So, Q1 equal to 100 minus, so Q2 equal to 100 minus Q1. So, substituting Q1 by 400 minus Q2 equal to 100 minus Q1 divided by 300 plus 100 by 250. So, rearranging 100 by 400, Q1 by 400 minus 100 by 300 plus Q1 by 300 plus 100 by 250 equal to 0. Rearranging the terms, 300 plus 400 divided by 120,000 Q1 equal to 100 by 300 minus 100 by 250 equal to 0.067. So, 7 Q1 divided by 1200 equal to 0.067 and Q1 equal to 80 watts. So, the amount of energy supplied Q1 equal to 80 watts. That is the answer we have selected from the previous slide. Now, this is the question from the 2008 question paper. A cyclic device operates between three thermal reservoirs as shown in the figure. The heat is transferred to or from the cyclic device. It is assumed that heat transferred between each thermal reservoir and the cyclic device takes place across negligible temperature difference. So, infinitesimal temperature difference. The interaction between cyclic device and the respective thermal reservoir that are shown in the figure for all in the form of heat transfer. So, all the value given here in the form of heat transfer. Cyclic device is a reversible heat engine, a reversible heat pump or a reversible refrigeration system, a reversible heat engine, a irreversible heat pump or a reversible refrigerator. So, this is the diagram. So, there is a three reservoir, 1 and 2, they are at temperature 1000 Kelvin and 500 Kelvin and the heat supplied is Q1 equal to 100 kilojoules, Q2 equal to 50 kilojoules and Q3 it is rejected to the, Q3 is rejected, amount is 60 kilojoules and the temperature is 300 Kelvin. Now, we have to check the condition. The correct answer is it is a reversible heat engine, we will see how. So, this is the diagram and for a reversible cycle Q1 by T1 plus Q2 by T2 minus Q3 by T3 equal to 0. So, the Q3 is rejected. So, we have Q3 by T minus Q3 by T3 equal to 0. Substituting 100 by 1000 plus 50 by 500 minus 60 by 300 equal to 0. So, this is 0.1 plus 0.1 minus 0.2 equal to 0. The condition is satisfied. So, this is for a reversible cycle. So, this is for a reversible heat engine. So, the diagram shows a reversible heat engine. The process describes a reversible heat engine. That is the correct answer. And this is from 2010 question paper. Consider the following two processes. First process, a heat source at 1200 Kelvin loses 2500 kilojoules of heat to a sink at 800 Kelvin. Second process, a heat source at 800 Kelvin loses 2000 kilojoules of heat to a sink at 500 Kelvin. Which one of the following statement is true? Process 1 is more irreversible than process 2. Process 2 is more irreversible than process 1. The irreversibility associated in both the process are equal. Both the process are reversible. So we calculate the change in entropy for change in entropy shows the irreversibility of the process. Change in entropy for the first process. So Q by T2 minus Q by T1. So 2500 divided by 800. So the temperature at which heat rejected, sink temperature is lower temperature. So 2500 divided by 800 minus 2500 divided by 1200 equal to 3.125 minus 2.083 equal to 1.042 kilojoules per Kelvin. For the second process, so the amount of heat transfer is 2000 kilojoules. The temperature, source temperature is 800 Kelvin, sink temperature is 500 Kelvin. So Q by T2 minus Q by T1. So Q equal to 2000 divided by sink temperature is 500 minus 2000 divided by 800 equal to 4 minus 2.5 equal to 1.5 kilojoules per Kelvin. Now the entropy change for the process 2 cycle process 2 is greater than entropy change for the process 1. So the correct option is process 2 is more irreversible than the process 1 because the entropy changes for the second process is more than the entropy change for the first process. And the next question paper, in an experimental setup, air flows between two stations P and Q adiabatically. The direction of the flow depends on the pressure and temperature conditions maintained at P and Q. The conditions at station P are 150 kilopascal and 350 Kelvin. The temperature at station Q is 300 Kelvin. The following are the properties and relations pertaining to the air. Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. R gas constant equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Enthalpy H equal to Cp into T and internal energy U equal to Cv into T. If the air has to flow from the station P to station Q, the maximum possible value of pressure in kilopascal at the station Q close to, the answer is 87 kilopascal. We will see how in the next slide. And if the pressure of the station Q equal to 50 kilopascal, the change in entropy SQ minus SP in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin is minus 0.155 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And option B is 0 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Option C equal to 0.160 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And option D is 0.355 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The correct answer is 0.160 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. We will see how. So the station P, I take state 1. So P1 equal to 150 kilopascal, T1 equal to 350 Kelvin. And the station Q, the state is 2, the temperature is 300 Kelvin. So the final pressure for the adiabatic process, the process is adiabatic, the final pressure at Q for adiabatic process P2 equal to P1 into T2 by T1 to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. So 150 into 300 divided by 350 to the power 1.4 by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 87.54 kilopascal. So the pressure is 87.54 kilopascal and the change in entropy for adiabatic process delta S equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So this is the expression for general process. So substituting the numerical value, delta S equal to 1.005 into logarithmic of 300 by 350 minus 0.287 into logarithmic of 50 by 150 equal to 0.16 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So that is what the answer we have selected in the next previous slide. So the pressure final pressure is 87 kilopascal. If the final pressure is 50 kilopascal, the change in entropy is 0.160 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is from 2011 question paper. And next question from 2012 question paper. An ideal gas of mass m and temperature T1 undergoes a reversible isothermal from an initial state, initial pressure of P1 and the final pressure P2. The heat loss during the process Q is Q. The entropy change delta S is given by delta S equal to MR into logarithmic of P2 by P1, delta S equal to MR into logarithmic of P1 by P2, and delta S equal to MR into logarithmic of P2 by P1 minus Q by T, and delta S equal to 0. And for isothermal process, the answer, correct answer is delta S equal to MR into logarithmic of P1 by P2. That is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer for isothermal process. And this question from 2014 question paper. An amount of 100 kilowatts of heat is transferred through a wall in a steady state. One side of the wall is maintained at 127 degrees Celsius and the other side is at 27 degrees Celsius. The entropy generated in watts per Kelvin due to the transfer of heat through the wall is dash. So, this is the arrangement. We have a wall and the left side the 100 kilowatt is the amount of heat transferred across the wall and left side the temperature is 127 degrees Celsius and the right side the temperature is 27 degrees Celsius and the entropy generator equal to Q by T2 minus Q by T1. So, the Q by lower temperature minus Q by higher temperature. So, temperature T1 is 127 degrees Celsius and T2 is 27 degrees Celsius. So, the amount of heat transfer is 100 kilowatts. So, 100 into 1000 divided by 27 plus 273 minus 100 into 1000 divided by 127 plus 273 solving the answer is 83.3 watts per Kelvin. So, the correct answer is 83.3 watts per Kelvin. The entropy generated due to the heat transfer. And this is also from 2014 question paper. A closed system contains 10 kg of saturated liquid ammonia at 10 degrees Celsius. Heat addition required to convert the entire liquid into saturated vapor at constant pressure is 16.2 megajoules. If the entropy of the saturated liquid is 0.88 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, the entropy in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin of saturated vapor is dash. So, we have to calculate the entropy of the saturated vapor. So, entropy of the saturated vapor. So, entropy change SV minus SL equal to Q, heat transfer divided by the temperature. So, entropy of the vapor equal to entropy of the liquid plus amount of heat transfer divided by M into temperature T. So, the amount of heat transfer is 16.2 megajoules. So, SL equal to 0.88 plus 16.2 into 1000 divided by 10 into 283 equal to 6.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, the answer is 6.6 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is also from 2014 question paper. Two identical metal blocks L and M of specific heat 0.4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, each having a mass of 5 kilogram are initially at 313 Kelvin. A reversible refrigerator extract heat from the block L and reject heat to the block M until the temperature of the block L reaches 293 Kelvin. So, the final temperature of block M in Kelvin is dash. Now, this is the layout, the diagrammatic representation of the problem. We have block M with the temperature, initial temperature 313 Kelvin, final temperature is unknown. It is L, it is T, we take T. It is a refrigerator, so it extract heat from the block L, which is the initial temperature is 313 Kelvin and final temperature is 293 Kelvin. So, work is given to the refrigerator and the specific heat and the mass of the block are equal. So, specific heat is 0.4 kilojoules per Kelvin, kilogram Kelvin and mass equal to 5 kilogram. Now, the answer is 334.4 Kelvin. The temperature is 334.4 Kelvin. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the diagram, block M and block L connected by a refrigerator and the entropy change of the block M. So, delta S M equal to MC into logarithmic of TF by TI. So, final temperature is unknown for block M and MC into logarithmic of T by 313. And the change in entropy for block L. So, delta S L equal to MC into logarithmic of TF by TI. So, which is MC into logarithmic of 293 divided by 313. Now, the change in entropy of the universe. So, it is the sum of delta S equal to 0. So, delta S equal to delta S of a block M plus delta S of block L. So, MC into logarithmic of T by 313 plus MC into logarithmic of 293 by 313. So, this is equal to 0. Entropy of the universe equal to 0. So, you substitute MC into logarithmic of T by 313 plus MC into logarithmic of 293 by 313 equal to 0. Or MC is getting cancelled. So, logarithmic of combining the two logarithmic terms. So, logarithmic of T by 313 into 293 by 313 equal to 0. So, 0 equal to log 1. So, neglecting the logarithmic term. So T by 313 into 293 by 313 equal to 1. So solving this equation, temperature equal to 334.4 Kelvin. So that is the answer we have seen, we have shown here, 334.4 Kelvin. And the next question from 2015 question paper. 1 kg of air of gas constant R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin undergoes a irreversible process between equilibrium state 1, 20 degree Celsius and 0.9 meter cube, and equilibrium state 2, where the temperature is 20 degree Celsius and 0.6 meter cube. The change in entropy S2 minus S1 in joules per kilogram Kelvin is dash. So it is an isothermal process. T1 equal to 20 degree Celsius and T2 is also equal to 20 degree Celsius. The volume, initial volume is 0.9 meter cube and final volume is 0.6 meter cube, and we have to calculate the change in entropy for isothermal process. So for isothermal process, the change in entropy delta S equal to R into logarithmic of V2 by V1, which is 287 into logarithmic of 0.6 divided by 0.9 equal to minus 116.34 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So the answer is minus 116.34 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Our next question paper from 2016 question paper. An ideal gas of mass M is contained in a rigid tank of volume V at a pressure of P. During a reversible process, its pressure reduces to P1. The following statement are made regarding this process. Statement P, heat is transferred from the gas. Statement Q, work is done by the gas equal to 0. Statement R, entropy of the gas remains constant. Statement S, entropy of the gas decreases. Among the statements, the correct ones are A, P and R only, P, Q, R only, Q and R only, P, Q and S only. So which is the correct answer among the four options? Now look at the process. It is a rigid tank, so it is a constant volume process. So during the process, pressure is reduced. So in a constant volume process, when the pressure is reducing, it is a constant volume heat rejection process. Then only the pressure will decrease. So for constant volume heat rejection process, there is no work transfer. Because of the heat is transferred, so heat rejection process, heat transfer from the gas. Statement P is correct. Constant volume process, work done equal to 0. Statement Q is also correct. Entropy of the gas remains constant, so that is not correct. Entropy of the gas decreases, that is correct, because for heat rejection process, entropy will decrease. So the correct statements are P, Q and S. So the correct answer is option D, P, Q and S. That is the answer. And this is from question paper. This is the question from question paper 2017 question paper. 1 kg of an ideal gas of R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin undergoes an irreversible process from state 1, 1 bar 300 Kelvin to state 2, 2 bar 300 Kelvin. The change in specific entropy S2 minus S1 for the gas in joules per kilogram Kelvin is dash. So it is again, temperature is constant, 300 Kelvin, state 1, 300 Kelvin, state 2, 300 Kelvin. So it is isothermal process. We have to calculate the change in entropy of the isothermal process. So for isothermal process, the change in entropy equal to delta S equal to R into logarithmic of P1 by P2. So R into logarithmic of 1 by 2 equal to minus 198.93 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So the correct answer is minus 198.93 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is again from 2017 question paper. A reversible heat engine E operating in a cycle interacts with the three reservoir 1, 2, 3 maintained temperature T1 equal to 500 Kelvin, T2 equal to 400 Kelvin and T3 equal to 300 Kelvin respectively. The engine receives 100 kilojoules of heat from reservoir 1 and rejects 3 kilojoules to the reservoir 3. The net work output from the engine is dash. The temperature T1 equal to 500 Kelvin, T2 equal to 400 Kelvin, T3 equal to 300 Kelvin, Q1 equal to 10 kilojoules, Q3 equal to rejected, so heat is rejected, minus 3 kilojoules. And for a reversible cycle, reversible engine, Q1 by T1 plus Q2 by T2 minus Q3 by T3 equal to 0. So we do not know about Q2, but the Q1 is positive, Q3 is negative. So substituting 10 by 500 plus Q2 by 400 minus 3 by 300 equal to 0. So Q2 by 400 equal to 0.01 minus 0.02 equal to 0.01, rearranging. So Q2 equal to minus 4 kilojoules. So Q2 is also negative. So now the net heat transfer equal to net work transfer. For a cyclic process, net heat transfer equal to net work transfer. So W net equal to Q1 minus Q2 minus Q3 equal to 10 minus 4 minus 3 equal to 3 kilojoules. So the correct answer is 3 kilojoules. So net work output from the heat engine is 3 kilojoules. And this is from question paper. This question is from 2018 question paper. 1 kg of air that can be considered as a perfect gas with R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin and specific heat ratio gamma equal to 1.4 undergoes a constant volume process from an initial static pressure of 1 bar to a final static pressure of 4 bar. The increase in entropy in joules per kilogram Kelvin of the air is dash again. So the constant volume process, the change in entropy equal to delta S equal to Cv into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So from the given data, Cv equal to R by gamma minus 1 into logarithmic of P2 by P1 equal to 287 divided by 1.4 minus 1 into logarithmic of 4 by 1 equal to 994.6 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So the correct answer is 994.6 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is from 2019 question paper. Water is flowing at a rate of 1 kilograms per second through a system is heated using an electrical heater such that the specific enthalpy of the water increases by 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram and the specific entropy increases by 0.007 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The power output of the electrical heater is 2.5 kilowatts. There is no other work or heat interaction between the system and the surrounding. Assuming an ambient temperature of 300 Kelvin, the irreversibility of the system is dash kilowatts. So, round off to 2 decimal point. The answer is irreversibility equal to 2.1 kilowatts. We will see how. In the next slide, we will see the answer. So, delta H equal to 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram, delta S equal to 0.007 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and power of the electrical heater P equal to 2.5 kilowatt, and the ambient temperature is 300 Kelvin. So, mass of the water M equal to P by delta H. So, power divided by the delta H equal to 2.5 divided by 2.5 into 1 kilograms per second. And the delta S of the system M into delta S. So, 1 into 0.007 kilowatts per Kelvin. Delta S change in entropy of the surrounding equal to 0. The change in entropy of the universe equal to delta S system plus delta S surrounding equal to 0.007 kilowatts per Kelvin. And the irreversibility of the process, irreversibility equal to the ambient temperature under delta S universe. So, 300 into 0.007 equal to 2.1 kilowatts. So, that is the answer we have used here in the previous slide. So, 2.1, irreversibility equal to 2.1 kilowatts. So, next question is from the year 1996 question paper. An iron cube at a temperature of 400 degrees Celsius is dropped into an insulated bath containing 10 kg of water at 25 degrees Celsius. The water finally reaches a temperature of 50 degrees Celsius at steady state. Given that the specific heat of water is equal to 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin, find the entropy change for the iron cube and the water. Is the process is irreversible? If so, why? The given data, initial temperature of the iron is 400 degrees Celsius, mass of the water is 10 kilogram, initial temperature of water is 25 degrees Celsius, final temperature of iron and the water equilibrium temperature is 50 degrees Celsius and CPW equal to 4186 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The heat loss by the iron cube equal to heat gained by the water because the hot iron cube is dropped into the water. So, heat loss by the iron cube equal to heat gained by the water. So, MICI into TI T1i minus T2i equal to MWCPW into T2w minus T1w. So, MICi into 400, initial temperature of ion cube is 400, final temperature is 50, equal to 10 into 4186 into initial temperature of water is, final temperature of water is 50 minus initial temperature is 25. So, we calculate MICi equal to 2990 joules per Kelvin. Now, the change in entropy of the ion cube, delta S ion cube equal to MICi into logarithmic of T2i divided by TNi. So, substituting 2990 into logarithmic of 50 plus 273 divided by 400 plus 273 equal to minus of 2194.9 joules per Kelvin. And the change in entropy of water, delta S water equal to MWCPW into logarithmic of T2w divided by T1w equal to 10 into 4186 into logarithmic of 50 plus 273 divided by 25 plus 273 equal to 3372.2 joules per Kelvin. And the change in entropy of the universe equal to change in entropy of ion cube plus change in entropy of water, which is 3372.2 minus 2194.9 equal to 1173.3 joules per Kelvin. So, the delta S universe is greater than 0. So, the process is irreversible. So, we stop here. So, thank you for watching. And you please post your comments on the YouTube comments box for the improvement of the video. And if you have any queries, you can contact through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So, if you like the video, please subscribe the channel and use all the videos for your better learning. Thank you, and we will meet again with some more problems from the GATE question paper.